Hey guys, it is Sharika, aka Cher. How are you doing? I am here to do my mid-month August update. And I don't know about y'all, but August has gone extremely fast. When I looked at the date and realized what day it was, I was just like, this is crazy. August is flying by. I wanted to share my mid-month update with you guys, compare what I originally budgeted to what I've actually spent so far. And it has definitely been a doozy this month, but there's a lot of good and, you know, a lot of unexpected things, but it's all been covered. So I want to share with you guys. I'm going to be sharing with you my app, the app that I use for budgeting. I use the app You Need a Budget, and the website. I've been paying for the subscription for several years now. I really enjoy this app because it not only helps you plan for the future, say when money comes in, you don't have to just put it to this month, but you can start putting money to further months in the future. And then two, I like to use credit cards to purchase most of my bills to get rewards points. I like the fact that for each transaction, I put which credit card is being used, and then it tells me how much I need to be paying on my credit card each week. Like I said in my previous video, I have a 20-minute Saturday morning routine that I do when I do my finances, and I make my payments, reconcile my bills. I do everything every Saturday morning just to make sure that my numbers are all in sync. So this morning I'm going to be showing you guys where my money has gone so far in August and all the money moves that have been made. All right, let's go. All right, so let's look at the August mid-month check-in. So let's look at the income first. Here I've got $70. So I bought my grandmother some items online that she needed, and she ended up just paying me back cash. Honestly, the stuff that she purchased was more than $70. Actually, when I had cash, I spent it. So some of the money I spent and the rest of it I put into my bank account by ATM. Next, I have my paycheck. So I've only received one paycheck so far, but if you see, I got three awards within that first paycheck. So that was really good. And that is why I kind of did a little bit of shopping for myself this month. But yes, I had three awards, and then my actual paycheck was $1,947.42, which was a little bit more than I expected. I think an adjustment that I made hasn't been actually made in the system yet. And so the next check should be a little bit shorter than that. But hey, I'm grateful. Next, I got my rent check on the 7th, and I input that, and you'll see later I'll make that payment. So total income for the month was $4,656.95. Yes, amen. Now we're going to drop down into the expenses. I gave $200 to the church, and then the next category are going to be my debt payments. So Mariah's student loan, I put $75 each check into my daughter's student loan that we have, and that was done. Then I made a debt snowball payment of $3,000 to my student loan. So that included the rent check and then some extra money from my budget. Then we've got Fed loans here for $52.84, which was in my budget. So that's the primary payment. That's the basic, you know, what I owe every month, which technically I don't owe because it's in forbearance because of the CARES Act, but I still make that payment. So the $3,000 plus the $452.84. So the total I paid was $3,452.84 to my student loan. Yes, I am knocking that bad boy out. So total debt payments this month, $3,527.84. That's awesome. The next category is my variable expenses. And so I put $75 in for gas. So far, I've only spent $22.20. For clothing, I didn't budget any money for clothing, but I ended up buying some things and I used some of that award money. I bought some orthopedic shoes, some shoes to wear around the house. I have serious problems with my heels, and so I can't just wear flat slippers anymore. So I decided to treat myself to some of those. And I work out on a regular basis, and so I decided to get myself some New Balance. And they were 40% off, so it was $38.15. In the food category, I budgeted
$125 in food, and so far I've spent $113.09. All right, so starting from the first, I spent $10.38 at Chick-fil-A. Then I went to Target and got some avocado oil. It actually was avocado oil, some Febreze, and some kombucha. I ended up just putting it all under food category. Keep it simple. I went out to Chevy's with a friend to eat dinner. And then I went to Meg Wegman's for milk. My mom needed asked me to get some milk. And then I went a few days later and got more milk because they drink milk like crazy in this house. And then one day I was out and about shopping for my daughter, and I decided to treat the entire family, my mom, my dad, myself, my nephew, and my grandmother to tropical smoothie. And so that is where that $113.09 came from. My fun money. This is money I give to myself. So for me money, I budgeted $50, and then I had to steal a couple dollars from another one. So it's called Red Octopus. I don't know if you noticed in the video earlier, I got my nose pierced. It was something I've wanted to do forever. I actually planned to do it for my 40th birthday in January, and I never did it. So one day somebody was like, hey, I want to get my nose pierced. And I was like, hey, I'm going to go with you. So $55.22 for me and my nose. Medical. And so my medical account or budget item goes a little bit all over the place. I have a flexible spending account. And so when I, you know, usually spend money for medical expenses, I usually get it back. And so I have, I paid for an emergency room visit, and I think I actually got the money for that earlier in the year. And actually, so here's the plus for that. I actually got money in here at the $30 for a previous appointment. This is an appointment that I went to one of a doctor, and I paid that out. And then I also got some money back in. So this account just pretty much balances itself out. Under gifts, which I'll eventually move under giving. So $100 for Financial Peace University raffle gifts. My mother and myself, we host Financial Peace University for my church and other people. We do this every quarter pretty much. And at the end of the 9-10 weeks, whatever we decide to do, we always raffle off gifts. And so we raffled off some Amazon gift cards. Then I decided a random act of kindness. I just sent a friend $25 just because I felt like it. Then we have the stuff I forgot to budget for, $307.99. So as I said earlier, some of these things are going to be things that my grandmother needed. I usually just order them for her, pay for it, and then she'll just reimburse me for cash. Some of it's just stuff I didn't need or didn't plan for. So we can start from the beginning of the month. I decided I just wanted some wine and I didn't feel like leaving the house, so I asked my sister to pick some up for me, and I cash-apped her money to repay her back for the wine that she bought. Then my daughter's tire blew, so I had to take money out of my auto savings account, which is over here, as you see the number of there. So I had to take money out of there to pay my parents for that tire. My dad ended up going to get the new tire for her, and I just paid him back for the tire. Then here is me. I have all my savings accounts are in Capital One through 60. It's me transferring that money into my account to cover what I gave them. So that balances each other out. And it was something I completely didn't budget for. Bed Bath & Beyond was something my grandmother wanted. Like I said, I paid for that out of my own pocket, and then she reimbursed me. Bath and Body Works. I was in the mall one day shopping, and I noticed that Bath and Body Works had the lotion that my mom wanted. It may have been sold out for a while, so I decided to gift her for that and budgeted and paid $28.62 for stock her up on some lotion for the next couple of months. And then Ulta. Although we're wearing masks all the time, there's a favorite lip gloss that I have. It's called Buxom, and the color is Sugar, and so it's $22.26 for that lip gloss. Then, of course, Amazon again. Grandma needed something else. I ordered it for her, and she paid me back. And like I said, so you saw the other one was 50 and the other one was 45. I ended up spending some of the cash she gave me. But like I said, we all balance out. And then we have Target. My daughter is going back to school next week, and she has her own apartment. So We went to Target and had to pick up some things for her apartment, and that total came to $144.62. I could have transferred money over to cover it, but because of the award, things ended up balancing out. And so those are all my variable expenses. Total, $637.68. Then my quality of life goals, and this is just miscellaneous things that I've spent so far. I've got two Patreons, which come out at the first of the month, so those came out, and then I bought some hair stuff moisturize my hair, which was $11.98. So that was $51.98. And my total expenses, $4,417.50. And I still have $239.45 left over